Today I have a fresh and a new isometric design tutorial, but we're not going to use a single grid throughout the entire process. Now I am nearly finished with the logo design process video, and that's going to be coming here on Wednesday. But now let's make some isometric designs using no grids. So here are some of the base colors that I'm going to use for my design. And to make life easier, let's add them to the Swatches library like so. So now we have some colors in the Swatches window, we can begin the isometric design process without the use of grids. First, I'm going to make a background by pressing M for the rectangle tool, and then covering the entire artboard with a shape. Now sampling colors from the Swatches window couldn't be easier. Just click the swatch whilst your shape is selected. Now lock down the background with Command or Control 2, or you can come here to the drop down menu. For my isometric design, I'm going to show you the techniques by working on the base first. Now it's important to make two edges the same length and the height. The actual isometric style is achieved in the 3D section under Bevel and Extrude. So right here, you can see we have isometric options, and I'm going to use the top version first. Now you can leave this with the two edges automatically generated for you, but I personally like to make everything manually because then I have 100% control over my design. But of course, you can use this option to generate the edges of your designs. It's completely up to you. To turn it off, drag this slider down to zero, and also turn off the shading to keep the original color of your design. So this is how we're going to be doing things today, but there is yet more to learn in this isometric video upload. Once the shape has been altered, expand the appearance so the bounding box fits the shape and it's more easier to work with. I'm going to show you one more time with this shape here. But for this shape, I'm going to use the left edge option instead of the top isometric generation. So again, don't use the shading option if you want to retain the original color choice that you did select earlier. As you can see, I do have the smart guides activated, which can be toggled on or off with Command or Control U. Another command that you're probably going to find useful is Command or Control Y, which will enter into outline mode. This helps us stay precise and, you know, line everything up efficiently. So the base is ready for my isometric design, but I want to have it in a different kind of layout. So I can just select everything and then reflect it in the transform window. I just prefer it looking this way for some reason. And also, of course, click the preview box to see your changes in real time. Now I'm going to add some interest and a unique quality to my design by elevating one element kind of hovering above. You can see in the outline mode, I've already gone ahead and made the isometric shapes using the previous methods. However, now I'm going to adjust the opacity of two of the shapes. You can obviously watch today's tutorial and then use the techniques to be creative and make your very own designs. But there is yet more to learn, so let's keep going. I've simulated two lines of text using the same isometric method, but I want to show you some of my layers in the layers window. It will help you a whole lot if you label your layers, because then you can keep track of things and it's going to be easier to move and select things around when your design gets more complex. so I'm going to duplicate the base layer and then change its color to resemble the shadow. Lowering the opacity here probably works best for my design, I feel. So as I mentioned, I do have text resembled as single lines, and I've gone ahead and grouped these three shapes together to make up one line of text. And of course, to do that, just press Command or Control G. Instead of going through the whole 3D isometric process that we looked at earlier, for these I simply selected this shape here and duplicated it by holding down the Alt Option key. I then grabbed the Direct Selection tool, which is A on your keyboard, and I shift clicked two anchor points and moved them upwards by holding down Shift. I then rescaled things with the Selection tool, and finally use the Direct Selection tool again to correctly extend the shapes outward, using the original lines as a kind of guide to keep the isometric proportions true. So here's a trick to keep the lines of your text isometric and equal distances apart. Line them up to the edge here, and then by holding down the Alt Option key, duplicate one exactly over. Then press Command or Control D repeatedly over and over again. You can then remove two lines at a time, and this will leave a precise column of text like so. And the green circle was made using the 3D process that we looked at earlier. And finally, let's create yet more interest and more uniqueness. In the Layers panel, I duplicated the three shapes that make up the base layer. If you want to properly scale this shape without distorting the isometric appearance, shift click and drag from this anchor point and not from the corners. Then I'm going to add a Gaussian blur to this shape, which is all part of the plan for this final technique. For this to not look pixelated, your design shouldn't be too small. And to make sure all the raster effects do look smooth, I'm going to raise the raster effects pixel tolerance right here. Now these are the techniques for making isometric designs without the use of a grid in Illustrator. I'd love to see your creativity when it comes to this kind of design, so do tag me on Twitter if you do make a design. But until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.